Since we have again the time, I'll just explain you one more time. LOC, so many are having the confusion in that. See, if you want to access it using indexing, you can directly write that. Am I audible to you all? Hello? Yeah.
Yes, ma'am.
So if you want to access the elements of your array using indexing, you can mention simple a single index over here. Suppose I want E. So indexing will start from 0, 0 and 1. You can directly mention over here SER, square bracket, and 1. So only E will come. If you want that this 5 elements should come, you can always write like this. This is set to be the slicing. So in this way you can write. But if you are using location, so in location, what actually happens? You can actually give the name of the columns. When we'll be using data frame, you'll get to know more. Since we are talking about 1D array, there is no columns, there are only rows. So if labeling has been given, if indexing has been given, you can write directly those indexing. If indexing is not given, then by default you can write by default indexing also you can write. But even though if you write by default one indexing, what it will do, it will include your all the elements including 3 to 6, which is not so in case of your indexing. After indexing use karte ho, you can see in the slicing also that if you use indexing, what happens ki jo bhi last element diya hua hai 5 indicates L length minus 1, that is 4th element. 4 indexing should go till 4. But that doesn't mean ki 5 elements nahi aane wale. Elements aapke 5 hi aayenge. But the indexing will be here till only 4. I hope you are understanding it. It's a bit confusing, but you should not get confused because indexing is separate and the number of items are separate. We are not talking about the number of items in the output. See, if it starts, we want 5 elements, but the indexing anyway starts from 0. If you will take it till 5, then it will become 6 in number. Understand? Agar main 5 tak leti hu indexing, to wo 0 se start ho raha hai. So it will become 6 in number, which we don't want. We want 5 elements only, and indexing is starting from 0. That is why we are taking 4. Now, slicing and I location are almost same. They are not different. But the only difference is that in slicing, you're directly writing it like that. But in I location, we use I location as a function in which only your integer operations will go. I location and slicing are here so similar, but you will. The major difference comes when the tables come into the existence. That means when 2D or multi-dimensional objects will come, there the major difference we can see. But for now, for 1D over here, slicing and I locations are almost same. You are only doing one thing is that you are using along with data I location over here, and in this I location, you are passing the elements over here. It will give the same output as your slicing is giving. It will not give any different output. The different output is only be given by the LOC. The example is here, see, if I have taken B and C, that means I have taken an indexing which I wanted to take. Index B se leke index D tak ke mujhe element chahiye. So in that case, deliberately I am writing indexing over here. Now see, while writing indexing also, since this is a character, I have to write it into this code. If it would be a number, I can directly write 1:3. But since it is a character, I'm writing it like this. Yes, Pradeep. You can unmute and you can ask the doubt.
Ma'am, by mistake it happened.
Okay. So now the location is like B:D, means B se leke D tak hame sab chahiye. So the location will be like B, C, and D. And when I go for I location, if I want B:D, that means indexing I have to mention. So indexing should start from, if I suppose I want from B:D only, the same elements which we are giving with location, I want the same element using I location, the indexing will be given as, since it should start with B, so starting indexing will be 1, 0 and 1. So 1:2, 1, 2 and 3. I wanted 3. So what I have to do is starting index is 1:4. Then only I'll get 2, 3, 4 as my output. Clear? Any doubts, then we can go with this. Otherwise, I'm moving on to now operations. So going on to the operations. First of all, you have to import your pandas as you wanted the pandas in this. Now see, you have not imported your NumPy. because you're directly using list. As I mentioned, you can use list also into the series. But if you're going with arrays, you have to definitely import your NumPy. So now, since I was using directly series, I have not imported my NumPy. But it's better, it's a good practice if you always import NumPy, because जब ये ऑपरेशंस ज्यादा बढ़ते हैं somehow you use your numpy function also and then the if it doesn't import it will show you an error. So now I've put my one of the series in data and I've put another series into your data one, and also you can see the indexing is given ABCD ABDE. So what happens then? See, if I print my data first, my data is this 5 2 3 7 with ABCD indexing. And if I put my data 1, its indexing is already given ABDE. So its data is like this. Now, if you want to add two series, we have to use dot add function. Now, using dot add function, what it will do first, it will add A and A. That its output should be 6. So you can see the output is here, 6. Now, B and B. So 6 plus 2, its output will be 8. Now, we are going for C. So we have only C as 3. Now see, our function has written fill value is equal to 0. If nothing is there, its value should come as 0. 3 plus 0 will be again 3. Now D is there, so D is 7. And we have here 4. So 7 plus 4 will be your 11. And similarly, your E. Now see, E is not there, but E is here. And its value is 9. So what it will do, it will take by default its value as 0 and E will be printed as 9.0. So this will be your output. It will be combination of both the data and data 1. One more thing I was saying you, that when you go for NumPy, in NumPy what do you do? NP dot, how do you write in NumPy? It's like NP dot add, and you write inside that array 1 comma array 2. But see the difference over here. When you use in NumPy add function, you write both the arrays inside it. But when you use it into the pandas, you don't do it. You write where one of the array here and another one over here. So if you do it with the pandas, what you will be writing over here is array 1 dot add, and then you will be writing your another element ki kisse aapko add karna hai. So the syntax is quite different. The previous class student was getting so much of confused while writing this. So make sure that you do not do such mistakes. Similarly, if you are using this subtract and we have the same data, so you can see the output over here. So what we were having in the output is, now we have the data 5 and A we have 1. So what we are subtracting data from data 1. So it will be 5 minus 1 will be your 4. So your output is your 4. When we look on to the B, it's 2 and 6. So 2 minus 6 will be your minus 4. जो भी फर्स्ट डेटा लिखा हुआ है उससे आपका नेक्स्ट डेटा सब्ट्रैक्ट हो रहा है. सो डेटा 1 डेटा माइनस डेटा 1, सो दैट्स व्हाई इट इज माइनस 4. इफ यू गो ऑन टू सी, देयर इज नथिंग, सो इट विल बी सी ओनली. इफ यू गो ऑन टू डी, इट विल बी 7 माइनस 4, सो इट विल बी योर 3. आई थिंक इट वुड बी वेरी मच क्लियर टू यू हाउ दिस ऑपरेशंस आर वर्किंग. द वन हु वाज हैविंग डाउट, आई थिंक इट वुड बी क्लियर टू यू नाउ. सो नाउ दीस आर द डिफरेंट फंक्शंस. यू कैन गो थ्रू द डिफरेंट फंक्शंस, यू कैन ट्राई डिफरेंट फंक्शंस ओवर इन योर IDE. Different functions type करके देखो क्या output आता है. Then this is the only way to learn the Python. You have to practice it. आप different arrays लेके देखो that if this value is not given in the array, how it will add. If this value is not given, then how it will perform the subtraction. How the multiplication will result. How the division will result. So you have to perform this and put it as an saved copy into your system for the journals. Now the last functions we have is our head and tail function. In head, what do we do? In others, we were having array as an output, but in head and tail, what we are having this as a function. Series will be the output for it. So create a series with 4 random numbers. First of all, we have created a series because we wanted an array for it. So we have created an, using an array, we have created a series. Now, for demonstrating you that how we can take the two rows of the data series, what can we do? We can use the head function. see h will be small, and in this you can mention n, that is 0, 1, 2, whatever the n is there, kitne elements aapko chahiye aap mention kar sakte ho. Now you don't have to specify over here 0, ye indexing nahi hai, aapko batana hai kitne elements aapko chahiye, kitne rows aapko chahiye. That means if you want 2 rows, then 2 will be mentioned over here. So by default it will take out anyway through indexing only. So now see, hence you are not, because you are not put any indexing, by default indexing is already there, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now we wanted 2 rows. So the first row will be 0th row and the second row will be your first row. So the output will be 0 and 1. This will be the output of the two head function. Similarly, if you want the last two rows of your data series, you can do it using tail function, T-A-I-L. And the last two will come out like this, last two will be your output. The last two rows of the data series will be your output like 2 and 3. Clear? Here, aap yahan par indexing nahi mention karoge. You have to just tell which, how many number of rows do you want? Which number of rows do you want? You want the third row, you want the fourth row, you want the last two rows, you want the last three rows. That you have to mention over here. N is there. It's not indexing, it's the position. But output will be according to the indexing. Kyunki series, everything works on indexing only. Am I clear? This is the end of the slide. Somebody has a doubt with returns the product of the value of the requested axis. Now see, this will definitely work when the data frame comes into the existence, where the table will come into the existence. Now see, when you add, we are only working with one single axis now, that is a row column axis. So what you can do, using add, we are only adding two series. But what if we have rows and columns both? In that case, you'll be using sum. आपको एक्सेस बतानी पड़ेगी कि आपको एक्सेस जीरो पे करना है, एक्सेस वन पे करना है. एक्सेस जीरो सेज योर वर्टिकल एक्सेस, एक्सेस वन सेज योर हॉरिजॉन्टल एक्सेस. इन द सिमिलर वे फॉर मल्टीप्लीकेशन प्रोडक्ट विल बी यूज एंड पी आर ओ डी विल बी द कीवर्ड यूज फॉर इट. सो रिटर्न द प्रोडक्ट ऑफ द वैल्यूज फॉर द रिक्वेस्टेड एक्सेस. द लोअर वंस विल बी मैक्सिमम यूज फॉर योर डेटा फ्रेम लाइक टेबल, अदर्स विल बी लाइक द अबव वन विल बी यूज फॉर योर सीरीज. नाउ बिफोर गोइंग, बिफोर एग्जिटिंग द सेशन, just let me show you the journal questions also, which will be helpful for you to understand that. So these are your journal questions. Four journal questions are there. First one says create a